So we ended the last stream with a basic setup of an Arduino, a breadboard, and a servo. We can control. So that's pretty cool. Now the next step is basically to not use the potentiometer at all. And to write some code that sends basically, okay. So, one sec. I have another one. Maybe I should just do the other one too. Okay, so I think the other one is basically identical. So we're just going to do the exact same thing. We just need some cables to power it, and then we'll have two. Then I'll write the code that parses the numbers, and then we can, okay. So just give me a sec. Oh. No, I'm a dumbass. This is female, so this is not going to work. But it is in brown, red, orange. So this would have been perfect. Okay, hold on. Hell yeah, I got super lucky. So, brown, red, orange. OK, Okay, so brown is ground. Red is plus. Right? Yeah, okay. Okay. And then the third pin is the orange, which gets hooked up to pin 10. Okay, so now if we just go here, okay. Okay, so now we want to just check that both of them load. Oh, we need to plug it in. This long ass cable. Okay, I think we're probably good. Oh, what? That's weird. Why is that? Can we just try it again? Sometimes it just works again. Oh, wait, you know what it is? We just gotta try it. This is like the worst part about doing this thing. It's so annoying. Is it 4? No. Oh wait, let's do this. I feel like this is the wrong way to do this, because this is how I do it every single time. Is it even doing it? What the hell is going on? How do I cancel? Wait, what did we try? We tried 4, we tried 6. Wait, did we try 4? Okay, 4 does not work. Did 5 work? Oh, okay, wait. Okay, so it's 5. Okay. Perfect. So now let's see. I don't really like to stand up on their own. Okay, there we go. Wait, but now this one's not going. What? That's weird. Nine and ten. Oh. Okay, I got it. Okay. Very cool. So now all we need to do is rewrite the code. So we can unplug this. Okay. Okay. I'm going to have float. Or I should probably say F32, where F32 are Rust floats. Formatted to string. I'm sending that over serial or to Arduino. Write Arduino func that parses the string into floats x and y. I mean the x and y part is totally obnoxious. This guy is dumb as hell. Okay, so we're going to do this. 5. We're going to put this here. Then we are going to copy all of this. Perfect. So that works. So now all we need to do is... Oh, crap. We need to reopen the... Reset. I think we just need to change that to a 1. Okay, so we need to close this. Let's see. Please tell me this does not... Oh, wait. The hell? I'm so sick of this. Please just let me read from this port. Uploading, done uploading. Why can't I do it? Okay, how to do it? I feel like it is selected. Why? Let's try it again. Okay, I'm just gonna close the Arduino shit. And I guess I'm closing this too. What the hell? Wait, this is the wrong one. What is this? Oh. What? I think that it should just be... one. Okay, so this we're gonna keep as it is. But then here... we're gonna copy over this guy. Okay, so now we have this is what I don't like about Servo. It's like... bleh. Okay, so now I should be able to... send... oh, wait. It doesn't... how do I upload this? Oh, perfect. Nice. Nice. Okay. Wait. Okay. I'm down with this. Okay, I think we got it. So now, the fun begins. Because this program is done, now all we need to do close the serial thing. Oh, wait, I'm a dumbass. Okay, so what I think is happening is that the invalid data that's being sent is this. Wait, actually, what is being sent? Oh. Still invalid data. Oh, wait. Here it is. This is it. Oh, it is totally working. This is sick. All right, we gotta figure out this delay though. What happens if I just get rid of that? Oh, it's way better. Okay, so imagine that we have this. Attached to here. That's what we gotta do. That is really cool.